Amen. Colossians chapter number 1, if you have your Bibles tonight. Colossians chapter number 1. Amen. And I just want to start off by saying I'm thankful for the wonderful week of revival that we had. I'll tell you what, it stirred my soul. God spoke to me. I was glad to see the church get revival. Amen. I was praying for it, and we got it. And I praise the Lord for that. And tonight, I wanted to give you a little bit of a message just for the church after revival, just a little thought just for the devotion time. And I just wanted to give you a little thought that will be an encouragement to you, because it seems like every revival I've been to, or most of them anyway, it seems like it's a good encouragement, and it's a good time to praise the Lord and have joy in our salvation. But it seems like very, very quickly, a lot of times, just maybe a month afterwards, we'll just lose motivation. And we'll lose that stirring of the Spirit that we had in that revival time. And I want to give you something that will keep you motivated tonight. I want to give you an exhortation tonight. And I thank the Lord for it. And I want to preach tonight just very quickly on what keeps me motivated and what can keep us motivated as a church. Colossians chapter number 1. The Bible says, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, and Timotheus, our brother, to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ, which are at Colossae, grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God and to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which ye have to all the saints, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof ye heard before in the word of the gospel in the word of the truth of the gospel, which is come unto you as it is in all the world, and bringeth forth fruit, as it doth unto also in you, since the day ye heard it, and knew the grace of God in truth. As ye also learned of Epaphras, our dear brother, fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. Now look at verse number 9. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. What keeps me motivated tonight? And what should keep us motivated tonight? I'll tell you what I see in the Christian world today, in spite of all that Jesus Christ has done for us, in spite of all that God has done in our lives and God has done in our church, God has done in our families, in spite of the wonderful testimonies that all of us in this congregation have, I've seen everywhere I go, it seems like Christians are just struggling. Good Christians are struggling to stay motivated, to stay true to God's word, to stay true to the gospel of Jesus Christ and sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. I think about those missionaries that we just shared, and it convicts my soul what motivation they've got to have to drop everything that they have in this great nation and go to some place that needs the gospel. I want that motivation tonight. I want to have that revival in my soul tonight. And God touched me with this, and I want this to touch your heart as well. So what keeps me motivated? Let me say by way of introduction, throughout all stages of life, we need motivation in our Christian lives. And I'm here to tell you, there's so many Christians who just limit God's power in their lives to certain seasons. They say, God, I'll go out and win souls for you. I'll go out and work in the bus ministry. I'll go out and work in frontline. I'll go out and win souls if these things happen. And if I'm okay financially, and if all these things are going well in my family, then I'll serve God. But no. God says to serve the Lord. Be instant in season, out of season. God gives us the work of the ministry for every single day of our lives. And every single area that we're at in life, every single chapter of our lives, it seems like we need that motivation. We need it through revival. We need it through riches. We need it through when God has blessed us and God, things are going well because of God's blessings. I've seen too many Christians get some stability in their lives and things are going well, but then once things are going well, they just use God as a spare tire, and once God has fixed their problem, then they're nowhere to be seen. Well, God told us in John chapter number 10, verse number 10, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy, but I am come that ye might have life and that ye might have it more abundantly. God is seeking to give you abundant life each and every day of your life. And I'm not for any prosperity gospel here, but I'm telling you, if you serve God, you'll find there's special purpose in your life. This world all around us is trying to find purpose, trying to find answers to all the world's problems, and trying to find their place in all of it. But if you'll identify with Jesus Christ tonight, he'll give you a special purpose and a special calling above everything else this world has to offer. And that is to share the gospel with the world. The Bible, the Great Commission is not just for preachers. The Great Commission is not just for pastors. The Great Commission is not just for people that are have been saved for 30 years. No, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. That is a commandment for every single man, woman, boy, and girl under the sound of my voice, to go into all the world. And we cannot do that if we're not motivated. So let me do a few, and let me show you a few things that keep me motivated and what I saw in this passage of scripture. Let's read again in verse number 9 very quickly. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it. So let's stop right there. I'm motivated to serve God because of my past. You know, a lot of Christians get this mixed up. You know, I'm all for looking into the day of looking into that blessed hope, and I'm all for looking to the day that we're all raptured onto the on home, and the day that God makes all things new, the day that God wipes all tears away. I'm all for looking to all those things, and don't get me wrong, I'm for preaching for them, and I'm for exhorting those times in the future. But nothing should motivate you more than the cross of Calvary. Nothing should motivate you as a Christian more tonight than Christ saving your soul. Your own testimony and your own salvation experience should be the greatest motivation and the greatest revival stir in your heart. I'm here to tell you, you don't need a revival service or a revival time to have a revival in your soul. Do you know what I'm saying? I'm here to tell you, you do not just have to have the songs and the sermons and everything that you think you need for revival. If you'll just look back to what Jesus did for you and he saved your soul, you can have revival every day of your life. It doesn't have to go away just because the preachers and the evangelist has gone home and we're not doing the special services. You can have revival every day of your life as a Christian if you're saved. And that's what stirs my soul. I think back to January the 27th, 2007, many times in my life when I get down and when I get just in a rut spiritually, I just think about what Jesus did for me and how Jesus changed my life. And it gives me hope and it gives me motivation. I'm motivated because of my past. Too many Christians are motivated by the future more than they are the past. And don't get me wrong, be motivated by the future. There is a great promise for everybody that's saved tonight. But don't forget what Jesus did for you. I'm motivated by the past. I'm also motivated, secondly, by a prayer, a special prayer for me every day. Look what the Bible says in verse number 9. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it. Look at this. Do not cease to pray for you. Let me give you a little context quickly. The Apostle Paul is talking to the church at Colossae, and he is praying for them. What he's saying, they're new Christians. They have just been saved, and they're just starting to serve the Lord. And he's telling them, hey, I'm praying for you. I'm in your corner, and I'm willing to pray for you and to stand by you. You know, there's something wonderful. I thank God that Jesus is the dearest friend that I've ever had. But on top of the blessing that Jesus is to me, I have people in this room that are praying for me every day. I think of my sweet grandparents that pray for me every single day. And the days that I don't get, that I'm just struggling with motivation in the Christian life, when the devil is just bombarding me with trials and tribulations and discouragement, I think about them praying for me. I think about my pastor praying for me and exhorting me and helping me and encouraging me in the ministry. I think about my parents who have raised me up in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord and have allowed me to go to this great church for 20 great years. I think of all the wonderful people that I can name off all throughout the night that have blessed me and encouraged me. And if I were to quit, how would I let them down? I don't want to let the ones that encourage me and the ones that invested in me and the ones that love me, I don't want to let them down. I'll keep on fighting. I'll keep on serving. I'll keep on preaching because of those that have prayed for me. And I'm telling you, that motivates me every day of my life. And it can motivate you as well. Be motivated by your past. Be motivated by prayers and supplications by those who love you. And you may say, Brother Andrew, I don't have anybody praying for me. Jesus is praying for you. Jesus is on the right hand of the Father. He said he's making intercession for you daily. You know what that means? He's praying for you. He's in your corner, and he's willing to help you. Be encouraged by the past and also the prayer, but let me close with this. Be encouraged by a great promise. Verse number 9, let's look to it again. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. I'm telling you what, I have a great promise laid up for my life. My life, not just in heaven, but for my life. I'm just getting started in the ministry. I'm just getting started in my Christian life. And let me tell you, brothers and sisters in Christ, I don't want to throw it all away. I don't want to give it all up. I don't want to give up what God has done for me, what my Christian, what my spiritual leaders, what my pastor, what my parents, what my grandparents, what those that have invested in me, what they have given me is not worth throwing away. And I don't plan on it. I thank God for the great promise I have. Look what the Bible says, and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will. There's nothing better than knowing God's will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. You know what that saying is? Or what God is saying is that God is going to give you peace and understanding through everything you go through. God never promised that the road would be without trials. God never promised that the road would be without its own struggles or trials. I'm here to tell you, God will give you peace that passes all understanding. God, listen to this. God has a perfect will for everybody under the sound of my voice tonight. You say, well, I'm not a preacher. I'm not a missionary. God still has a perfect will for your life. God still wants to do something wonderful with you. God wants to use your family. God wants to use your life. God wants to use you tonight. Don't throw it all away. Don't sacrifice what God has given you. Be motivated tonight. Don't let revival fade away from you as the days go by. Have revival in your soul each and every day of your life. What keeps me motivated? I'm motivated by a great promise for my life. I'm motivated by a great. I'm motivated by prayers by prayers of the saints and those that love me. But I'm motivated most of all because of what Jesus did for me. Be motivated by that tonight. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the day you've given us. Bless this sermon going, or bless the service going through. And I pray that you bless the singing, bless the preaching of your word. And I pray that all of us would grow spiritually throughout the service tonight, and that you get us where we need to be motivated to serve you to the best of our abilities. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.